we're talking about Hildegard von Bingen, and that's because her movement is going to be the second movement on To Shiver the Sky. I always knew that I wanted to start the album off with Sogno di Volare, because it has it's a great opener, right? It's big and it gets your blood pumping, it gets you all excited. I needed to sort of dial down the drama just a tad after Sogno di Volare, and Hildegard von Bingen was a great text to use in the second movement for a number of reasons. Chiefly because the way I'm structuring this album is that I'm taking all these great writers and thinkers and poets and philosophers and so forth, and I'm arranging them chronologically so that their texts essentially tell the history of aviation. And secondly, with that particular structure, I thought, wouldn't it be interesting if, as we're progressing through the history of aviation, we're also progressing through the history of Western music in a way. And so the earliest movements start with sort of a musical style that's indicative of medieval music or ancient music. And as we get further along into the text, as we get into, you know, Copernicus and Jules Verne and then Amelia Earhart and Yuri Gagarin and JFK and whoever else I'm using, you know, we progress through the eras of music. So medieval to Renaissance to Baroque to classical, impressionist, romantic, modern, postmodern. And I just thought that was just kind of a clever concept. However, concepts don't always lead to good music. And so I wanted to tackle Hildegard first because I wanted to see if I could get away with this concept. Because at the end of the day, if I have to choose between being strict with a concept or just making good music, I'd rather just make good music, right? So Hildegard, in a way, is a bit of a test run. Hildegard is, well, one of the interesting things about Hildegard herself is she actually was a composer herself. And so I turned to my old friends Anonymous Four, the early music singing group that actually disbanded a couple of years ago, but I'm still in touch with a lot of the singers. And I put on some of their recordings just for some inspiration because, you know, Hildegard's chants, they're monophonic plain chants, right? And for a moment, I thought, maybe what I should do is I should actually quote Hildegard, like take, you know, a melodic fragment of hers and actually build my piece around hers. But ultimately I found that that wasn't going to work for me. Now that chant is called Beata Nobis Gaudia. And it's lovely, I think it's beautiful. But obviously they're singing different words than the actual words I want to use. The actual words that I want to use are, they're here. Qui sunt I qui nubes volant et quasi columbae ad fenestras suas? And that means, who are these who fly like clouds and like doves to their windows? Going off of that, I decided not to use her chant, but I did sort of write a melodic line that's similar to hers, and it goes like this. At that point, it becomes a question of how do you evolve that monophonic line so it sounds like a complete melody, but then has enough interest to it to build to a big cadence, right? Because my music is about building to moments. Like, you're always building to something. And so we start here. Here's where we really start building momentum. It goes, quo dicitur. You'll notice that my bass is rising, and that kind of, you know, sort of ratchets up the tension. And then this next phrase here. I've repeated the words, but I've actually made the range of the melody expand. So previously we go, and then next we go. So we expand the range of that phrase, and that helps us build momentum, right? But then I actually switch gears on you just a little bit, and I go. So we were building up to something, but now I'm sort of denying it to you. I'm taking us in a different harmonic direction momentarily. And then we go. That's desiderio, right? And then these last three bars is where I really put us back on the rails towards a big climax, right? And I go. Here's the end of Sonia de Volare going into my Hildegard movement. So here.